first guest tonight is an Oscar-nominated and Emmy-winning actor, rapper, and hands down the best Riz in the biz. His latest movie is the psychological thriller Encounter.
Hey, when you get back to school, can you imagine the crazy stories you're gonna have?
Can I tell them about gunfiring? Pew, pew, pew.
I mean, I'm not sure if you could tell them. That's top secret, dude. That's just for the crew. That's just for the musketeers. But you can tell them you went on a crazy road trip with your cool-ass dad, okay? Yeah, just smile. Smiling's the best disguise. Okay, it's a little bit too much. It's scary. Dude, you're looking like an alien yourself now. Just smile normally.
Encounter opens in theaters tomorrow. Premieres on Amazon Prime Video December 10th. Say hello to Riz Ahmed. I like this outfit. It looks great on you. I would look so stupid in that. Just so incredibly stupid. I wouldn't even be able to get out. I'd get out of my car and I'd have to get right back in and go home.
I think you could pull it off.
I don't think so, no.
It's actually from the last show for Louis Vuitton, designed by Virgil Abloh.
Who passed away. Oh, wow. Oh, that's a nice tribute. Yeah. And happy birthday. It was your birthday yesterday, Do you say how old you are? Is that something
yeah,
you
Yeah, I'm 39.
39, all right, yeah. 30. Oh, yeah, all right, that's a big one.
I'm going to say you don't look 39.
You really don't look 39, but you probably hear that a lot. I'm surprised you're 39. I really would have guessed like 32.
So am I.
You sneaks up
on you.
What
happened?
Yeah. What'd you do? Did you have a party? Did you do anything?
So actually, some family was in town, so I went to Universal Studios.
You did?
Yeah.
What are you, eight? Really?
Clutching at straws, you know, trying to go backwards. Yeah, I've never been. So I decided to go and check it out, you know, just... Yeah, grabbing onto the inner child with both hands.
Yeah.
So I went. I was a massive Transformers fan as a kid.
Oh, okay. And they have a thing there, a Transformers thing?
They do, but it was kind of weird for me.
Why?
In the end. Well, because I was the oldest person there by 30 years.
Oh, yeah. First of all. That's weird, yeah.
So that was weird.
That's when you got to pretend you have a kid and you can't find him.
Exactly. That's even more creepy.
Yeah, maybe so, yeah.
So I turned up and I saw Bumblebee.
Oh, yeah,
he's like the big yellow Transformer, speaks in radio.
Mm-hmm.
And I was so excited to see a massive Transformers fan as a kid. So I was lining up, and Bumblebee does a bit where you play 50 Cent's It's Your Birthday. So the guy running the controls is playing that, and the people whose birthday it is are coming up, they're dancing with him, he's dancing with kids, women, all this kind of stuff. So I'm there. I'm excited. Like, I'm very, very excited. I've got my phone out, it's in selfie mode, I'm ready to go. I go up, he plays It's Your Birthday, and I start dancing, and I look up, and Bumblebee is just giving me the stink eye. I just look at him, and the look he had in his face, I think he hated me, man.
Oh.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. I haven't been able to get it out of my head
is
since.
Is it real?
And I'm thinking, if Bumblebee is watching at Universal Studios, I think I might know him and might have done something to him in the past. If you're there, I'm sorry for whatever it was.
Did you ever consider the possibility that Bumblebee may have been starstruck, or maybe Bumblebee usually only celebrates children's birthdays and he's like, what is this guy doing? I'm a Transformer. He's an adult.
That's a possibility.
Yeah, yeah, it could be either one of those three things. Yeah. Well, I hope there's no bad blood between you and Bumblebee. Yeah, I'd hate to see your childhood memories be soiled in that way. Yeah. It's just horrible. What were your childhood memories of birthday? Do you have, like, traditions in your family, something you guys did every year?
Yeah, well, I had a tradition that I thought everyone did, but I realized it was just my family.
What was
it? It's basically, let's say it's a kid's birthday. They sing happy birthday for that kid. He blows out the candle, he cuts a cake. But then all the other cousins will be crying out of jealousy because it's not their birthday.
Right, yeah.
So instead of, you know, us kind of teaching kids, you know, wait your turn and stuff, we just recut the cake for every single kid in the family.
You light the candles again?
We light the candles again, sing it again in English and in Urdu. And everyone would just, by the end of it, the cake looked like a murder victim, you know? It just, like, 15 kids had just cut that cake,
maybe this
waxed
is why,
all over it.
This is why you think you're 39, is you had so many birthdays as a kid. you're miscounting or something. Exactly. That's very odd. That is very odd.
Yeah. Thanks. Thank you.
Yeah. Because my kids will do that, but, you know, we usually get them a little present, you know, to kind of make them not feel bad about the avalanche of presents the other one is getting. But we never really thought about recutting the cake.
It's still bribery, what you're doing.
It's definitely still whatever. It's bad parenting, whatever it is. Yeah. So you so you celebrate your birthday. You have this movie now, and I have to tell you something. I'm not sure what I'm allowed to say about the movie, other than that kid was super cute.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's all we can say, really.
Is it really?
Because we should just move on. I don't really know how to talk about this.
I know I can say it's very interesting.
It's a fascinating movie.
Yes.
Let's just say that.
That's all you can say.
Yeah, check it out. Check it out. It's interesting because it's one of those films where if you say anything, you might give things away.
Right. Right.
But what I will say is, you said it's a psychological thriller.
Yes, psychological thriller.
So we can say that. Uh-huh. That's safe. Yep. We can say that. Mm-hmm. We can say that it's about a father-son story. Mm-hmm. You know, it's really about a father trying to keep his family safe at all costs in a very uncertain world.
Yes. And you have two boys in this movie.
I do, yeah. Two amazing, amazing
That little
actors.
Boy we just saw, who's super adorable, and then his older brother, who was how old?
I think at the time they were like 8 and 11 or
8 and
10. Yeah,
okay.
So you got the older one, Lucian River, just an incredible actor. And you got the younger one, Aditya Gadada, again, incredible. But they're amazing in totally different ways. But they're still amazing. You know, they say you shouldn't work with kids and animals. I thought that's because it's chaotic.
Yeah, well, you saw what happened with the dreidel dog.
Right. Yeah. Right. For me, it wasn't that. You shouldn't work with kids because they're just better than you.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I was just getting my ass kicked every day on set.
You felt like that?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they were amazing. Oh. So I'd be on set and, you know, I'd be looking around for him thinking, oh, it's the kid's first time on a film set. Let me, you know, try and make him feel better, give him some candy. I'm looking around for him. I look over. He sat in the car that we're filming in an hour before the scene, just crying, just ready for the scene, just like, just doing the thing. I'm just like, I got to up my game, man. I was going home every day just going, I got to up my game. This kid's kicking my ass every day. I'm here trying to make him feel better. He's like, not right now. I'm getting ready.
Wow.
I'm getting ready for the scene. I'm like, okay. So he's amazing. That freaked me out. So then I start hanging out with the other kid a bit more, Aditya, and he's like a master at improv. He's just like, I promise you, not a single line in the film that he says was in the script.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Wow. So I'm like, this guy's so confident. He's amazing. Find out today we're doing interviews. He's never read the script.
Can he read?
He did it. I think so.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I think so. But I was like, the whole time I was like, that's great, man. I was thinking, I should improvise more. But he was like, dude, you just don't read the script.
That's a heck of a piece of acting advice.
Yeah, so these guys were like my teachers. They took me back to acting school. They teaching me kind of opposite things, but...
So I will say about this movie, two things. It's really good, and you're in it.
Great.
Yeah, okay?
That's good.
And happy birthday. Riz Ahmed, everybody. And final rolls in theaters tomorrow on Amazon Prime Video, December 10th. We'll be back with Nicole Byer. Thanks for watching. Remember, every time you click the subscribe button, one of your enemies gets destroyed.